The videos you are currently watching come from a major model. This model is called Longcat. This model boasts very powerful generation capabilities, such as text-to-video, image-to-video, long video generation, and even interactive video generation. Now, why do we refer to it as a major model? Let's share a short story so everyone can have an intuitive understanding. Kijai began paying attention to this model right from its initial release and created a branch, hoping to reproduce this model within ComfUI. From the time he started creating this branch until we could use it, it took approximately 2 weeks. So you can see the effort Kijai put into this model. Currently, this model has been integrated into the One Video extension. You can open its sample workflow. Here we can see a workflow named Longcat TV. What does TV mean? It means this workflow can achieve both text to video and image to video. I will build all the workflows onto Running Hub. Everyone can access this platform through Running Hub in the ComfUI domain. Running Hub is an excellent online workbench. This is because whenever new models or new extensions appear, it follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description. This will grant you 1,000 free credits. Additionally, you get a gift of 100 credits every day you log into Running Hub. This allows you to try out your own workflows. Next, let's look at the image-to-video workflow. First is the loading of the main model, loading our Longcat FP8 main model. Then it needs to load a LoRa. This LoRa is used for acceleration because with normal sampling, it requires at least 30 steps of sampling to get a relatively good result. After adding this LoRa, we can achieve a good result with just 12 sampling steps. Therefore, this acceleration LoRa is the same as the Light X2V we usually use. After that, we enable chunk swapping here, setting the number of swap chunks to 20. Regarding model downloads, there's also a list provided here. Everyone can download the model according to the corresponding link. Next is our VAE, which uses the 1.2.1 VAE. Since this is image to video, we will have an image processing step here. Here I have an image of a beautiful woman in front of a concrete wall. Then we perform a resize. What is the standard for resizing? You must pay attention to the resolution. I have set the current resolution to 832 by 480. This resolution cannot be set arbitrarily. There is a list of acceptable resolutions, and everyone should try to use the resolutions listed in this table. First, we need to set a sampling scheduler. This scheduler was developed specifically for the Longcat model. Likewise, our steps are set here to 12 steps. As we mentioned earlier, thanks to the acceleration LoRa, the steps can be reduced to 12. The shift value is also fixed. Here it is 12. After that, we proceed with the first video generation. We need to connect the original image to the node called source image. Then through this node, we will get a start image. Because this is the first step, we can only get a start image. Here, we need a value called overlap. This means that during sampling, there needs to be an overlap between frames. This is to ensure better consistency. How many frames overlap? We set this to 13 frames. Then we proceed with our one video encode, encoding it into a latent space. Then we set an empty embed, which you can consider an empty latent space. Our reference image mentioned earlier is connected to extra latent, serving as an additional condition for the latent space. Similarly, we set the frame length here. That is, how long of a video will this sampling step generate? We have a setting here. Note that it is 93 frames. Everyone should try to ensure it follows the 4 and I1 rule. After that, we get the starting latent for sampling moving down. There's a very important node. This node looks very familiar, especially like our sampler. However, Kijai has split it out. Its current name is One Video Sampler Setting. What does this mean? It is the sampler settings. Essentially, all the configuration items encountered in standard sampling are present here as basic settings. After obtaining these settings, the subsequent sampling process becomes very simple. You can think of our original sampler as a combination of these two nodes. Therefore, the overall structural change in Kijai's program is quite significant. After sampling is complete, we will get the final video effect. Please note, I use a separate prompt for each sampling step. The encoder used is the 1.2.1 encoder, which is the UMT5 encoder we mentioned. You should note that my first prompt says the woman is walking forward and she has a very elegant smile. Currently, it is 93 frames. That's right, click and take a look. You can see 832 by 480 resolution, a frame rate of 15 frames per SE cond, and 93 frames currently. Then we move to the next extension. Note these two samplings look similar, but they are actually different. We now connect the result of the first sampling directly to source image. Then we will get a source image and a start image. You must pay attention. In the first step, we only had a start image. There was no source image. This is because source image refers to the video pass from the front, since there was only an image before, not a video. Here we only have the start image, but here it is different. The path taken by the start image is the same as before. However, during the final processing, there will be an additional node. This node is actually identical to the first one, both called image batch extend with overlap. The function of this node here is to connect the original video generated in the first step with the video extended in this step. Finally, we get the extended images, which is the extended video. This node is absent in the first step. Therefore, although these two samplings look the same, they're actually quite different. The prompt in this step mainly emphasizes changes in lighting. Let's take a look. Now we have this effect. Okay, let's continue to extend. This process is the same as before. In the prompt for this step, the changes shown are more significant. That is, she walks up to a large glass door. Then we can see here, she walks up to a glass door. The fourth step involves her trying to open the glass door. Let's check, she does indeed make this motion. The last step, logically speaking, should be her walking through, followed by a camera tracking shot. However, the execution of this part is not particularly good. She does approach the camera, but she does not walk through. So, you will notice that as the extension continues, the control exerted by the prompt continuously weakens. Thus, we end up with a video like this. Let's synchronize the actions. She starts walking, walks up to the glass window, then pushes the door, but doesn't enter. Now, let's discuss a few aspects. Firstly, this kind of extension is quite flexible. Following this approach, you can extend it to any length. However, you will notice that as the video extension continues to increase, look closely at the person's face. There will be some unnatural artifacts. It somewhat resembles the images generated by Flux, which have a very strong plastic texture. Let's look at some other examples we tested. For example, this one. Initially, it is a very beautiful female elf holding a sword. Then, notice that as the extension increases, pay attention to her face. It starts to look very bizarre. Second, everyone will find there is a more troublesome point here. The prompts. This is what is referred to as its interactive control. I can assign a separate prompt for each video segment. Then, it can generate a video according to my prompt. The LongCat model can achieve a very smooth transition between the various video segments. Therefore, we get a video of relatively good quality. Here we find that writing the prompts is quite tedious. If we want to extend 5 times, we have to write 5 prompts. Based on these 2 characteristics, we will now refactor the entire workflow to make it easier to use. Our goal, of course, is full automation. Let's look at our refactored workflow. Let's briefly examine the basic structure of this workflow. First, note that my settings here are exactly the same as the previous ones. There are no differences. The configuration items are also completely the same as before. Below that are our image processing and our scheduler settings. I have put these into a group here. Let's first look at this image. This image features a classical Chinese beauty on a canvas, with the Chinese phrase post-80s programmer written on it. We resize it. Similarly, for the scheduler here, we choose LongCat. Then we enter the first part. The first part is also exactly the same as before. I won't elaborate further. Let's just talk about the differences. The difference lies in the prompt. The prompt here is automatically generated. Notice that I have an extra section above here. We take the initial reference image. This is a segment of prompt engineering. This prompt engineering is essentially to get it to help us generate the corresponding prompts. In this section, I am actually telling it that I currently have an image, and it needs to advance the video plot based on this image. I hope it writes a prompt for each scene. Of course, there are many detailed rules here. You can check them if you are interested. Ultimately, we will generate a segment of prompts. Here, we need to tell it the number of shots we want to generate. We call this number of shot. I currently set it to 3. The reason I set it to 3 is that we just saw that with 5 shots, the person's face distorts severely later on. Therefore, I request that 3 shots be generated here. At this point, you will see that there is 1 line per prompt. We save it as prompt list and feed it to this node. This node is called prompt line. It can extract a specified prompt from a list of multi-line prompts. You need to notice I am currently extracting the prompt with index 0, which is the first one. How many do I extract? I extract 1. This is the prompt we are currently seeing. I have displayed it here. This is actually the first sentence we saw earlier. Then I will generate a video segment. The girl starts to turn around and puts down the brush. Below, we enter the extension part. Note that the extension part is not extensive. I only have one loop. This is because generation and extension are different workflows. We mentioned earlier that they are conceptually different in terms of workflow analysis, so they cannot be written together. After I generate a base video, the extension process can essentially be standardized. Here, I use a loop. Notice that video 0 is the first video we just generated. Then I connect it to loop start, and this is the end of the loop. How many times do I loop? I loop twice. Why twice? Because I have a total of 3 shots. The initial video segment was already generated here. How many are left? 2 are left. So the count here is 2 below. We need to extract the prompt. Since I have already taken the 0th index, when retrieving from here, my index must start from 1. So I add 1 to the loop index. This way, I can ensure that the prompt extracted corresponds to the current loop step. Then we enter this loop. I connect the video generated in the first step to initial value 1. This becomes value 1 here. I retrieve it and connect it to source image. This workflow is exactly the same as before. After that, we can connect the extend image output back to initial value 1. This means that initial value 1 will be updated in the next cycle to be the combination of the first generation and the first extension. Then we proceed to the second loop. Once this loop ends, we can retrieve the final video. Let's look at what the final generated video looks like. It has a very fantastical effect. So trying to write such a prompt yourself is practically impossible. You probably wouldn't think of all these details, but you will find that a large language model can help you construct these fantastical scenarios. Let's test another example. I now change the reference image to a man and a woman watching the sunrise on a mountaintop. We don't need to change anything else. Let's generate it now. Okay, the sampling is complete. Let's take a look. The overall sampled result is quite good, as you can see. Of course, as the extension increases, the image quality actually decreases. However, after 3 sampling steps, the effect is not yet very noticeable. This concludes our discussion on image to video. What about text to video? It is very simple, we just need to remove this part, the image input, and that is it, because this is an empty latent, and the extra latent is used to inject the reference image as a condition into the latent space, achieving the image to video goal during generation. Now let's look at the text to video workflow. You can see that we have no image here. Consequently, the extra latent is not needed here either. However, our prompt engineering must be changed. At this point, you cannot provide an image and then write the prompt based on it. We can only provide a theme and then explain what we want to generate. I have prepared the English version of the prompt engineering and the Chinese version of the prompt engineering here. My theme here is a female secret agent attempting to open a safe. The number of shots is 3. Let's try to generate it. Let's look at the generated result. The female secret agent is trying to open an old safe. Later, there is a surprise and explosion scene. I think the concept of this story is also excellent. Well, that is all we have for today. What are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it yourself. Follow me to become an AI expert.